Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm feeling really quite grateful for the way that the community is responding to our YouTube channel. So today on growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers, I want to look at a few more community building tools, and I have a treat for us. As I was preparing to do a webinar earlier this week, I was working with a woman named Susan Shangle, who I've met at several different places, but primarily because we're both part of a Google Plus training group that's run by Martin Shervington. Now, fortunately for us, Susan is a far better student of this group than I am, and she was working with me and looking at our YouTube channel and exactly what the integration is between YouTube and Google. Google Plus social network. And she opened my eyes to some very cool things that I was missing and not doing correctly. Now, rather than just continue on, what I did is I stopped and we recorded the whole session, which I'm going to give you a link to right here if you want to watch it. It's about an hour long and it's just a conversation between Susan and I that I recorded as we walked through this entire process. But what's going to follow here now for this particular episode of Growing Your YouTube channel is going to be my Reader's Digest condensed versions of things you can do in YouTube connecting to Google Plus to help grow and honor your community. Whew. Well, thank goodness for people like Susan who has the patience to walk me through what I don't know about Google Plus and its integration with YouTube. But I'm sure Susan would also be wanting to give some credit for what she's learned from Martin Shervington's Google Plus Your Community or Plus Your Business group, where I know she learned a lot of this content from. But she was able to boil it all down and give me a really nice, concise kind of a task list here of what I should be doing to help support our community here on the Dotto Tech YouTube channel. So one thing I've done well is dealing with all of the comments. My daily routine starts with me. The very first thing I do is go into our comments area in YouTube and reply or acknowledge each and every comment that comes in. And it's not that many comments. It takes me about a half an hour to do it because it's often a little bit of research as I look for answers. But what I was doing, and I'll just walk you through what I was doing, and then I'll add on, I'll layer on what Susan taught me here, is I would go into the community in the morning, and here's, I've already done it this morning, but it's now a little bit afternoon, so there's a few new comments in. I haven't posted a new video in a couple of days, so there's not that many comments right now, but when I go into community, here's all of the different comments that we have. And as we look through the comments, I used to just go through and I just used to reply or give thumbs up to all of the comments that I would find. And we can see here on the right-hand side that it's telling me which video it's related to or if it's just a channel comment. Now, I thought that that was a really good start, and it is a good start. It tells the people who are most important, the people who are on your channel all the time, that you're paying attention. I think it gives credibility to the channel. Plus, I learn a lot. I learn what you're interested in, etc. But I never looked very closely as I was going through this at exactly what activities each of the people were involved in. So, for example, we get down to this post from Ross, and it says here that he shared it on Google+. What I wasn't paying attention to was the hierarchy of love that comes on Google+. People commenting on your posts shows that they're engaged, and it's a big help in the Google world. But there are even better things people can do for you than just commenting on your posts, as far as building your reputation, building your authority, and helping you out where it counts, which is in Google search. Sharing your post, especially sharing it publicly and not sharing it to a private group, but sharing it publicly, is the most overt expression of support as far as Google's concerned. Google looks at people whose posts get shared and they say, wow, those people must have valuable content, and so they elevated their rankings in search. So looking for those markers as I go through is something that I hadn't been doing, and now I am going to increasingly do. Now, there are, as in all Google world, there's multiple points of entry for us to do any activities. So obviously, as you go through, just replying to the comments, it's a nice interface now when we click on reply. reply, it plus mentions the person that you're replying, so they get a notice back. And if they have shared you on their wall or on their Google Plus account, your plus mention here will also go back to their page, which is another good start. So I'm still saying that what you should be doing very first is going through and dealing with all of your comments here, but it's at that point there that my eyes were really opened. In my routine, once I finished replying to all the comments of the community, I would go under this notifications bell here. I would click on that, and I would bring down all of my Google Plus notifications. Now, this brings down everything that happens to this account. This account that I run my YouTube channel with is my Dotto Tech account. It's not my personal account. So these are all the notifications that happen of any groups that I'm in or any activity at all on that Dotto account. So you can see there's been, since I last cleared them out, there's 17 or so that are here. Now, I thought in my naivete that this, when I click on this one here, that people adding me to their circles was the highest form of love. And so I would go through these, but I always thought I was doing myself a great favor by taking each of these people here and adding them to a circle of my own called Top YouTube Fans. And I would go through. And this is still a good thing to do. And to be fair, circling me, adding me to one of their circles is a high form of support. It means that people want to be notified. It's like subscribing to the channel, but kind of a step beyond that because they want notification of activities on my channel. So adding people to that Top YouTube Fans is still a good thing. I might name that circle differently now, but it doesn't matter. The bottom line is that since I started doing this maybe about a year ago now, I've added a total of 2,800 people through this that have circled my Dotto Tech channel themselves. But that's just the beginning, and that's almost the lowest hanging fruit, because as I go through now and look at the different comments that people have added, I will come to comments like this, which is, this person mentioned, they did a mention of me in there, did a comment back on me. So if I now highlight or move my cursor over top of their image, I can go and I can see that I've got them already checked off as somebody who's commenting on my posts. So I can, now this is the hierarchy: sharing, commenting, and plussing my posts, followed by circling me, which is in this case the Top YouTube Fans. And that's the hierarchy of love coming our way from Google Plus. If somebody shares your content, that's the best. If they comment on your posts, that's the second best. If they plus your posts, that's a little bit easier than commenting because it's just clicking a plus. That's the third best. And if they circle you, it might actually be better, but we're going to classify that as fourth best. So I've set up these circles, and you can see I've got very few people in a lot of those circles right now because I've just started them as of yesterday, adding the people. So I went through and people who commented, I added to. So I'm not going to have to add this every time somebody does a comment, because I'll see when I hover over them that they are indeed, they're already in my comment circle. Now, if they plus posted me, or if they share me, and if I see them again, I will add them to the share circle. Now, what does all of this adding these people to the circles mean? Well, in the beginning, right now, what we're just doing is we're just kind of, it's almost like mail list building, as we're building groups that we know what their level of engagement is with us. We will, there are ways that we will be talking about downstream that we can start to work with these groups, especially when we're in a product launch mode or when we're gathering information. There's going to be a variety of different ways that we can work with these, but these are our more solid fans on YouTube and in the Google Plus universe. So being able to identify who they are as we move ahead is going to be increasingly valuable. And as those numbers increase, they will become even more valuable. So right now, it's just basically, I'm just setting the stage. I'm sowing, I'm preparing my fields to sow a crop. I don't know how big that crop is going to be and ultimately what it's going to look like, but I'm going to now every day go through this. And here's another, that's actually the same person that they shared several posts in a row, or they commented on several posts in a row. So we'll continue on looking. This person commented, so it's Christina. So let's highlight Christina, move our cursor over top, and let's see, she's not in any of my circles yet, so I'm adding her to the comment because she commented on one of my posts. Now, when somebody shares you on their wall, it's a good idea, or on the shares you on their Google account, it's a good idea to visit their Google page and take a look and make sure that you're commenting back right on their, right within their account. Again, they're going to know that you're back. They're going to know that you're respecting and that you appreciate the fact that they posted. And so you create that interaction. These aren't just, these are more serious as far as I'm concerned than Facebook likes. And it's a much better opportunity for engagement than Facebook likes. I believe that we build communities in YouTube one link at a time, one person at a time, by answering a question, by thanking them, by posting the video that's perfect for them, by posting a video that they requested, that they were interested in. We build our fan base or our community one person at a time. And by going through and basically massaging this information as we work our way through it and making sure that, that's just a group that I'm in, and by making sure that they know that we appreciate what's going on with them, I think that that's going to ultimately just pay off big time over the long haul. Now, having said that, let's take a look at the second kind of stuff that Susan taught me, which is dealing with my own Google Plus account here. I have done very little. In fact, too little. I've done precious little in the fact that I would just post basically, it's all about Steve all the time on my Google Plus page, and I would just basically post my latest videos. And there would be comments coming on those videos, but there was very little interaction with me other than any comments that happened to be reflected back from me commenting in YouTube. But Susan showed me the coolest tool on the planet for Google Plus people. It's right here. It's this little carrot. When I click on that, look what pops down, the ability to pin this post to the top of the page, and that's useful, but here's where it gets really interesting, to create an embed link for the post, and later on I'll show you how to view the ripples, which is also really, really cool, and also to view the post activity. But first, I want to talk about embedding the post, because if you've been following my series, you know that I follow a very rigid publishing routine for all of my videos. I publish a video on YouTube first, then I cross-post that video onto my own blog, which is where I want to drive people to. But I think that if I choose the embed post here, copy this text, which is just basically an embed code, and I copy that, and then when we jump over into my WordPress blog, onto my webpage. If we take a look at my webpage, I'll show you what the difference is. In the past, I would just post the video. And it looks like if we take a look here on my latest posts, this second post here, do I like my new iPhone? That's done in the classic Steve model. This is a YouTube video posted on my blog for people to see, that right there. And then I would take that and of course I would cross post that to Facebook. Susan suggested that I consider not posting the video from YouTube, but instead posting that blog post or that page post that's happened in the Google Plus profile on my page. And when I post that and I put that embed code, this is how the post then looks on my website. Now, I'm not sure I love it yet, but I'm not sure I hate it. But I'm just kind of coming to terms with the difference that it might make as far as search, because I'm getting a great deal of additional social proof. Now, this bottom set of social proof, of Facebook likes and Google Plus shares, etc., this comes from the social sharing tools that I have built into WordPress. So it's basically mainly reflecting Facebook. But look here, it's only saying that there was 3 Google Plus shares. That's because that's where people shared when I shared it on my own page. But in reality, this post already has 14 pluses, or 14 not shares, excuse me, pluses, and it has 6 comments. So by posting this here, I create the opportunity for people to see the additional social proof that's happening in Google and engage with that. It doesn't look quite as nice, I would say, as this post, but it does more for me as far as building my brand in the Google universe. Plus, they can also follow me right directly from this from the post, and they can also see, you know, proof of other people who have posted right away or plussed or commented on the post. And of course, they can just click in the center and view the video in a slightly smaller form than I have in my embed from YouTube. It's an option. It'd be nice if I could strip away a little bit of the extra stuff. I'd rather not, say, have this header image here of the Dotto Tech, and I'll play with it to try and figure out if I can do anything around that. But the bottom line, though, is that is going to be an interesting option as a different way of cross-posting your content, possibly with far more impact in the Google search universe, which is something that we all want. So hats off to Susan, and thanks so much for showing me this idea. The final two things that I'm going to show you on these posts is I'm going to scroll down to a different post here. Here it is here. Google's hidden gem, Google Forms. So this post has done quite well as far as its sharing and the amount of traffic that it's had. It's probably, I think, around 60,000 views. So it's a nice example here. So I'm going to click on the carrot now once again, and I'm first of all going to take a look at the post activity. Now this shows me all of the pluses, all of the shares, and all of the comments and the people that have done that with this particular post. But there's another tool in that carrot called View Ripples, and this is really interesting. This creates a kind of a mind map showing where the post originated and then how it spread out through the internet. And watch this. If I click on this little play button here in the bottom left corner, it actually shows it over time as the post got shared out and which people had more links to the share. And we can see that it's a larger bubble for people that had more shares and more interaction. And we can see that this post over a 5-month period has just continues to keep growing and growing and growing and growing. And so that's a really interesting presentation of another way of seeing the data as it goes through. So Google Plus, mastering some of these skills in Google Plus is essential as we move ahead. Of course, we haven't even spent time yet talking about what we do with these people once they're in the circles, but that is for another video. I want to keep this one relatively short and shorter than the video, the hour video of Susan and I talking through all of this. So if you want to see the unedited version, watch the video. But for now, you have a much better idea of how to interface your YouTube account and your Google Plus account. I've got to thank you all for tuning in. I hope you found this video useful. And there's three ways to, of course, stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. The second is sign up for our newsletter. That way you'll hear about any upcoming webinars and events that we have as we teach these different topics, as well as you'll get update of all my newest videos. And finally, this video comes to you ad-free because it's part of the benefits of being a Patreon supporter on Dotto Tech. Dotto Tech is supported by crowdfunding through Patreon. If you want to know more about what Patreon's all about and discover some of the perks involved in being a Dotto Tech supporter, including access to my online courses, then please drop by our Patreon page. That is it. Once again, my thanks to Susan Shangle. You should check her out. She knows her Google Plus stuff, does that woman. I am Steve Dotto. Till next time, have fun storming a castle.